Wisdom knows no east or west. Suffering and misery are universal. Who can show us a road to freedom from pain? The Buddha, the awakened human being, found a door that opened to a realm beyond samsara. Holding that door open for us even today in Calgary, Tripitaka Master Hsuan Hua taught us how to end suffering for ourselves and how to share that path for every living being who can hear. Today in Avatamsaka Monastery, we have the devoted laity, YQ Ma, Eva Yu, Jim Liu, Zhong Su Lianxue, Deborah Lee, Spring Liu, Alan Chan, Catherine Dung and family, Jackie Chang, Connie Liu, Liu Junjie and family, and Daisy Chow, who have brought forth that rare resolve to seek awakening in the midst of confusion. For you now, I will bestow 6 tools of genuine cultivation, according to the Venerable Master, his very method of practice suited to this time in this world, the real Dharma that carries us from endless affliction to freedom. What is that method? Watch our thoughts the way a gardener watches green sprouts in the springtime. When fighting, contentious thoughts arise in that garden, counter them with yielding, patient thoughts. Banish affliction from your wisdom garden. When greedy thoughts sprout up on the mind ground, weed them with the shovel of generosity. When seeking, discontented thoughts arise like crabgrass in the lawn of Bodhi, compost those thoughts with the priceless backhoe of contentment. When selfish thoughts choke your chan garden, sweep those thoughts clean with the magic broom of unselfish and selfless action. When thoughts of private benefit smother your altruism, share the good things with a wheelbarrow of sharing. And when dishonest thoughts cover your mind ground with dust, mop that garden clean with the immaculate mop of integrity and truth. 6 tools for turning the mind ground into a living garden of wisdom, a place where you can go for shelter from the storm, for serene reflection, a place where you can welcome the Buddhas, the Bodhisattvas, the Dharma protectors, and the spirits of the Avatamsaka assembly. Because, as the ancients said, only where all is clean will the spirit abide. When the mind ground is in samadhi, one can make that great Bodhi resolve. You can say, ultimately, my potential is the perfect wisdom of the Buddha, but immediately, my resolve is to cross over all living beings with the 6 guidelines, which are the Buddha's precepts experienced on the mind ground. So I have a question for all of you today, kneeling there in the middle. With this method in our grasp, who can fear the road to Bodhi is too far from us? Good men and good women, if it doesn't start with your very next step, where will you find it? So the verse says, the road to awakening leads back to the mind. With the very first step is the universe of 1,000 worlds, Cultivate six thoughts. In emptiness, a gate opens ahead. Spring breezes through the maple trees. The laughter of children on the playground.
Chinjing the Divang, Tainan, Huan Yin,
心地在坚固的禅定的时候，我们都可以发大菩提心。大菩提心怎么讲呢？就说究竟的目标是要向佛圆满的大智慧，可是立地都要用六大宗旨度一切众生。 换话来说，这是心地上所修成的佛的戒律。今天有问题，向你们十四位来提问：知道这个妙法，谁能怕菩提路太遥远呢？善男善女人，善男子、善女人，如果 成佛的道路不在脚底下，去哪里找到成佛的道路呢？所以有一个偈颂就说， The road to awakening brings us back to the mind. Take the first step, you find the universe of a thousand worlds. Cultivate six thoughts. In emptiness, a gate opens ahead. Spring breezes through the maple trees, the laughter of children on the playground.